So this is going to be a very different Enzo that we see next season, right?
Yes. How we left off last season was, Damon and Enzo going on this killing rampage. We will find out why and what they're driven by, and it's something to do with this new supreme evil that has been lurking in the vault, that has escaped the vault. And Enzo, however, is kind of grappling with this a bit more. He's fighting it a bit more than Damon, and that's how we start the season, is seeing the whole relationship with Damon, Enzo, and this creature, we'll call it.
So the creature of the supreme evil, we saw the hand. Do you know, are we going to see that embodied in any way other than you and Damon?
Yes. I'm not sure what I'm allowed to say on that matter or not, but it is a being of some sort. Yeah. I think I'm allowed to say it.
Does this feel like a good place for the story to start to wrap up in your mind, or are you disappointed that it's not going to keep going many more seasons?
I think it feels like a good place. I mean, where do you stop otherwise? I mean, it can become just a kind of cop show, an episodic kind of thing, that, you know, like Scooby-Doo type thing. And I feel like the great thing about this, by doing a somewhat shorter season and having an endpoint in sight, is that they can really hone the focus, drive it towards the end, as opposed to going, what can we throw in now to keep everything occupied? 22 episodes is a long-ass time to be able to fill. So, I'm super excited about that, and I feel like it is a good place. You know, all the characters are kind of finding their footing in a way. In a way, I suppose. And we'll find out how that all kind of happens at the end, whatever Julie's vision is for the closure, which I'm super excited to find out about myself.
So those two won't be just out on their own all the time. You will get to interact with the rest of the cast sometimes, right?
Oh, I have to. Yeah, I mean, the beauty, I was going to say as well, the beauty of this season is everything's focused on the group. You know, the group is looking for Damon and Enzo, so everybody is together. Whereas I think in seasons past, there's been a lot of different things going on, kind of missions with you know, Enzo and Sarah Salvatore, and then Damon and Elena, and Stephanie and his thing, with Klaus and all that. And so this is, everybody's together. All the storylines are kind of, you know, working in the same direction, in a way. You know.
What's happening with the Enzo and Bonnie storyline?
Well, you're going to get a whole lot more of that. There's some more Enzo-Bonnie stuff coming up as well, which, by the way, was a joy to shoot. Kat and I had a blast doing it. It was really, really great part of last season. But yeah, obviously, it's kind of on a bit of a hiatus based upon the situation at hand, with Enzo being locked down by this force and then being away.
What do you think of Enzo, like what is Enzo, where that the character of Enzo gives you personally that no other character will give you? Why are you going to be his mother?
Oh. God, we're getting deep. I mean, it's not even evening. I haven't had a drink yet. I don't know how I feel about that. I mean, so, you know,
he's funny.
I see what you mean. I mean,
so, like, the one thing Enzo brought you that you think you're never going to get a chance
to. Well, I always feel like I'll always have the chance to explore avenues, but I think probably the living on the edge, living in the moment, really pursuing what I want to pursue relentlessly, and I kind of a bit more fearlessly than I probably did before. And I feel like he's made me a bit more like that. And I feel like all the characters I play, I'm influenced by, and still carry with me to this day. You know, I played Elvis for a year. He's a part of me that has always retained that kind of thing. You know, you can't help it. You become somebody. It's like living a second life legally.
What ending do you want for Enzo?
Happy ending. Nice happy ending. No, sorry, it's my phone off. I mean, since I've been living with him and experiencing his wants as well, I want for him to be happy. So I'd want him to probably end up with Bonnie and be content and not have any sort of crap to have to deal with, because that's what he wants. So I want my character wants.
But is that going to be possible, seeing like the dark turn that he has now? Can he redeem himself and have a happy ending?
Well, that'll be the whole season for you to enjoy that whole trajectory. And I think that'll be a lot of what the season's about for Enzo is in each episode, you know, finding that out. I don't know yet, but I'm assuming so. But that storyline is definitely still strong, the Bonnie Enzo thing. They're going to explore it.
Is there anything you wanted to do with Enzo that Julie and Kevin might actually greenlight this season now that it's the last?
I wanted to ride a horse. That'd be another ending. Maybe something happens, Bonnie and him don't end up together, and he can ride a horse off into the sunset, you know, wearing one of those Clint Eastwood
canvas.
Yeah, you know. You don't have a happy ending with a horse.
Is it going to be sad, though, saying goodbye to the rest of this cast now that it is definitely the final?
Oh, hell yes. I mean, I love all these people. It's become my family the past few years. I was saying earlier, it's rare for some shows to even go as long as 3 seasons, and I've been doing this, is going into my 4th. Wait, is that right? Yeah, 4th season on the show. 5, 6, 7, 8. Which is nuts. And, however, when you have those kind of close bonds, you still keep in touch. You know, I reckon from this point onward, every time I'm in LA, I'll hit up Paul or Matt or Ian or anybody at Zach and just be like, yo, what are you guys doing? Let's grab some lunch. I mean, it's that close. It's family. It's like family. It's corny, but it's true.